Welcome to another episode of Teradata TechBytes. My name is Tim Miller, and I am on the Advanced Analytics Product Management team at Teradata. I'm here to talk to you today about a recent release of a new feature for Teradata Vantage called the Analytics Library. This is the first of a four-part series that will include three demos. Today's episode will give you a high-level overview of the Analytics Library. So what is the Vantage Analytics Library? It's based upon technology that's been in the marketplace since the early 2000s, and as such, is robust, flexible, and very mature. Its SQL-based analytic functions have been refactored such that the SQL generation and orchestration has been implemented as stored procedures running in the Vantage platform. It's been tested and is compatible with all Vantage releases and deployment options across AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud. It's easy to install and requires a very small footprint, very minimal amount of space, and most importantly, it installs directly on and only requires the advanced SQL engine. What are the benefits? As I said, it's lightweight. There are several supporting tables, one external stored procedure that generates the SQL, and two supporting table operators. There's no additional infrastructure required. Vantage Analytics Library allows you to use all of your data. There's no need to export the data out of the Vantage platform to perform your analytics. And it's proved to be very, very performant. It inherits Vantage's MPP architecture and linear scalability, so your analytics run at scale. It's been shown to have high concurrency, so that multiple function calls can run without impacting your overall SLAs. And it works with workload management, so that if you throttle based on the external stored procedure, all the SQL that it generates inherits that same workload. So what type of capabilities do you get with the Vantage Analytics Library? It can be broken down into these four different types. First off, you get descriptive statistics. So understanding your univariate statistical properties of your data, your distribution analysis, and data quality or data profiling on your entire data set, as well as the data that you transform or engineer and get ready for analytic modeling. It also has data transformations so that you can transform and engineer your data into a format suitable for the predictive modeling. It has hypothesis tests, so you can perform statistical tests to assess the plausibility of one of your hypotheses by using a combination of the enterprise data in the SQL engine, as well as various probability distributions. And finally, there's a set of commonly used multivariate and machine learning algorithms, such as linear and logistic regression, factor analysis, decision trees, clustering, and association rules. So let's look at this functionality at a little more granular level, starting on the left with descriptive statistics. Values is your basic data quality. How many nulls do I have to deal with? How many unique values? Positives and negatives, that sort of thing. Frequency gives you distributions of your categorical data, while histogram gives you distribution of your continuous data. And univariate statistics provides you the basics from min, max, mean, and standard deviation through much more complex calculations such as variance and coefficient of variance, percentiling, deciling, ranking your top five and your bottom five in modes. Overlap looks at key column consistency across multiple entities. Adaptive histogram takes care of the problems that you see with histogram, which is spikes or a frequently occurring value, as well as it just so happens that all my data is within a small range of bins. Text field analysis allows you to load varchar data if you do not know the DDL, and it will generate DDL for you. Bin code leverages those histogram algorithms from the descriptive stats family to represent a continuous data element as a set of bins as opposed to the actual value. You can do any kind of formula derivation that you can think of. You can do design coding like one-hot encoding if you need to represent your data in a numeric fashion for a series of zeros and ones. Null value replacement can be done on the raw data, or it can be done all as a result of one of these transformations generating a null value. You can recode categorical data elements, you can rescale continuous data elements, and you can do statistical transformations like sigmoid and z-score. From the hypothesis test family, we've got parametric tests such as t-tests and f-tests. We have binomial tests. We have tests based on contingency tables such as chi-square and median. We have a variety of KS or Kolmogorov-Smirnov tests. And finally, we have rank tests. And in the advanced analytics category, from the classic multivariate statistical algorithm, we've got linear logistic regression as well as factor analysis, and all of those are based upon being able to build a matrix at scale, a correlation or covariance matrix directly in the database, and we have that facility to do that. I've had that for quite some time. Linear regression and logistic regression also have their stepwise variance, forward and backwards, as well as scoring algorithms. A nice new feature, this actually was not in our previous release, is micromodeling by segment. So you can basically add a group by to your algorithm, and then you can simultaneously build many models, one for each of those segments that you're grouping by. Factor analysis has that same feature. We also have k-means clustering and its scoring algorithm, gain ratio decision trees and its scoring algorithm, and association roles or sequence analysis for doing market basket type of analysis. So how do you use the Vantage Analytics Library functions? Currently, there's two different ways, soon to be three different ways. Today, you can use it via SQL. So if you looked at the leftmost box here, you can see this is how you call a stored procedure. And it is literally a call prefaced by a database name. And then the name of the actual external stored procedure is td_analyze. The first argument you see there, k-means, is the function you want to run. And then the next set of arguments are a specification of the data, so the database where you want to run, the table that you want to run against, and the columns within those tables. And then you've got a set of algorithm-specific arguments. So the k-value is the number of clusters. Iterations is the maximum number of iterations, in this case of 10, or the threshold for convergence, which is 1/10. Looking at the other box with the green fonts, we're showing a Python version of this. And this is currently available in Teradata ML, and as I said, soon to be released in TDPlyr. There's first some configuration information, which basically is telling it which database that the functions are installed in. And then the way that Teradata ML works in general is that first you set a data frame to your table or view in the Vantage SQL engine that you want to run against. And then that is the data that is passed in. This data frame does not bring all the data over. It's a virtual data frame that just brings the metadata associated with that table over. So the way to call it is vallib.kmeans. We're talking about this equivalent that we just talked through in SQL. Then you pass in the columns. You pass in the centers, which is your k value or the number of clusters, the number of max iterations, which are 10, and the threshold value. So again, available from downloads.teradata.com today, the Python version, and R will be available in just a few short months. Thank you for watching part one of the TechBytes series on the Analytics Library. The remaining parts in the series are actual demos of the Analytics Library using the Python language along with the Teradata package for Python called Teradata ML, all within Jupyter Notebooks. I will show you how you can use the power of Vantage in the Analytics Library for data exploration and discovery, data preparation transformation, and finally for predictive modeling and scoring while using the power of Python for visualizing the results. I hope you will join me for these demos. Thank you again, and have a nice day.